My presentation is regarding how to understand the target, the victims. Please, next. What is a victim? Victim is any person who has suffered harm such as physical, mental injury, emotional suffering, or substantial impairment of his or her fundamental rights through acts or omissions that are in violation of the criminal law. The victims are not only the direct victims. Can you hear me? It's okay. Also, we're including indirect victims. Who are the indirect victims? It's the immediate family or dependents or even colleagues of a direct victim. Maybe you're cooperating with the victim. And also, you have also an attack related to discrimination because you are cooperating with this person. Now, for the victim, a survivor-centered approach. First, recognizing and prioritizing the rights, needs, and wishes of the person who has experienced discrimination or violence. Second, and very important, to create a supportive environment, ensuring the safety and dignity to enable a survivor. Next, please. Now, approaching the victim of discrimination. There are many ways. Organizing seminars and workshops for non-discrimination. Organizing educational programs that raise awareness about the mechanism of prejudice and intolerance. Distributing information, for example, through information campaigns. Providing legal and psychological support, counseling, and establishing contacts with national and local authorities to make the concerns of victims of discrimination visible. Don't underestimate the national and local authorities. It's not always easy to contact a local authority or a national authority at Convista, but please try. Now, Daniela? Okay.
Sorry.
Next, please. From this? Okay. Now, guiding key principles for working with victims. Confidentiality, safety, respect, non-discrimination, and honesty. Try to be honest. Don't pretend, don't be more soft than you need to be. It's better to be honest with them and respect their personality. Next, please. Practical tips for interacting with victims of discrimination. A clear message, how you perceive the situation. Explain your role and responsibilities and that you are there to support the survivor. You have to be clear with your role and your responsibilities. Ask what would make the survivor feel safe right now and whether they have any immediate needs. Because sometimes the person may be confused, may be angry, may be in pity. Please choose a way in order to feel safe and open him or herself. Use a survivor-centered approach. Reassure the survivor. Explain that all the information will remain confidential. This is very important because most of the victims are afraid. Show non-judgmental and supportive attitude. Use an empathetic voice. Listen carefully. This is very important. Not in every situation. Please listen. Try to listen. In every conversation, you have to listen. Emphasize that violence is not their fault. Because sometimes the victims, especially women that are suffering from violence on their husbands, most of them feel that this is their fault. No, emphasize that it is not their fault. Please, Daniela. How interview the victims of discrimination? Start by having a conversation. Be human. Building rapport and trust. Be affirmative to build trust. Introduce yourself and your project in ways that are easy to explain. Also, you receive guidelines from me in the very good presentation of Daniela that was before this presentation. invite the victim to describe what happened, their feelings and their thoughts, and use open-ended questions. Also, this was in the guidelines and also in the draft. Next, please. Empowering victims of discrimination. Victims should have the opportunity to participate in activities that are aimed at their empowerment through the delivery of efficient and quality services by service providers and through local victim empowerment forums. This is the aim of our project, or CENTRI. What should be provided? General and specialized resources on equal treatment and non-discrimination. Services at the state level specialized in certain discrimination grounds. Regional and local resources, followed by information on how to file a complaint. Empathy can reduce prejudices. By sharing a sense of common identity with other cultural groups or by arousing feelings of injustice. Empathizing with victims who have suffered from discrimination is essential as it may lead to people to reconsider their assumptions regarding the victim blame, and they may come to believe that the victims do not deserve the mistreatment to which they are being subjected. This is not easy, but I think that especially with our project, we have the opportunity to find new paths in order to go in this way. The steps of developing empathy are immersion, experiencing, feeling what the other person experiences, feels. In the case of victim of discrimination, trying to feel what the person describes is very important. Observation. Observing the people's behavior in the content of their lives. And engagement, interacting with the people, interviewing them. Try to put yourself in their position, but don't draw yourself in their position. I don't know if it is clear that I'm saying, feel yourself, but not draw yourself in their position. Next, please. Can we increase our empathy? Empathy requires cognitive, emotional, behavioral, and moral capabilities to understand and respond to the suffering of others. Compassion cannot exist without empathy. People who spend more time with individuals different from themselves tend to adopt a more empathic outlook towards others. Reading novels can help foster the ability to put ourselves in the minds of others. Meditation has also been shown to help cultivate brain states that increase empathy. Compassion are necessities and not luxuries. Without them, humanity cannot survive. This is something from Dalai Lama.